Hello everyone, welcome to my lecture series of data structures and algorithms. I hope you have gone through the previous lecture in which I have explained you the introduction of stack. So now in today's lecture we will study about the push operation, that is also called as insertion in stack. So before understanding the algorithm of push in stack, or you can say insertion in stack, we should understand some of the points which will be used in the algorithm. So the case one is when stack is full and we further try to insert an element, that condition will lead to overflow condition. Now let's understand this concept with the help of a real life example. So in your home, when you have a bucket and you are filling it with water by a tap, so what happens after the water, after there is no capacity in the bucket and it is full and you further the tap is on, so what happens? Because there is no capacity in the bucket, the water, extra water that is coming will overflow from the bucket and it will fall on the floor, right? So we have observed this thing in our real life also. So this condition is called as overflow. When the capacity of stack is full, let's say the size of the stack is n and you are further trying to insert one more element, then it will have this condition of overflow. Coming to case two, when your stack is empty, right? So we know that in the previous lecture also, I have explained to you in the introduction of stack that there is a pointer called as top in stack, right? So that top pointer is always point to the location where the last element is being placed. But when there is no element present in the stack, in that case, your top will be pointing to -1, which indicates that the stack is empty. In case three, when the stack is full, so if the, let's say the size of the stack is n, so the first index will be 0 and the last index will be n-1. Similarly, if I say the stack is of size is equal to size, so last index will be size -1. So when your top is pointing to size -1, or you can say n-1, that is the last location of the stack, it indicates that your stack is full. Now let's understand it with the help of example. So we will be now understanding the push operation in stack, right? So here we have a stack whose size is 4. So first index is 0, last index is size -1, that is 4-1, which is 3, right? Now we can see that these cells, these blocks are empty because there is no element in the stack. So in that case, as we have discussed in the previous slide also, that top will be -1 because there is no element in the stack. When the stack is empty, your top will be pointing to -1. Now I will first insert some data into this stack. In that case, your first element will be inserted at 0th location, right? But before inserting, we have to increment this top by 1. So now when you are trying to insert the element, your top will be -1 + 1, that is 0. So then your data will be placed at 0th location. So first condition is you have to first increment the top by 1, and at the new top you will be inserting the element, right? So let's insert the first element and we represent it with data. So see, I have inserted the first element in the stack and it has been placed at 0th location. So now your top is no more pointing to -1, but it is now pointing to 0th location, right? Now when I insert the next element, then again what will happen is first we will increase the pointer, stack pointer, and it will be 0 + 1, that is 1. Now your stack will be first pointing to the first location and then your data will be inserted, and you can also see this through the animation that first the top is incrementing and then the data is added. See, first top is incremented and then data has been placed at the first location. Again, I will insert one more element into the stack. So in that case, again, first your top will be incremented. So 1 + 1 is 2, and at the new top, new updated top, the data will be inserted, right? So you can see from here, first your top got incremented and then that data was placed on that new location. Now finally, we will be inserting the data at the last location. So now the top will be pointing to the last location, which is size -1, which is what? 4-1. So we can clearly indicate that your top is now pointing to the last location. And Now, when the capacity of stack is full, when we cannot insert any more elements into the stack, and you further try to insert one more element into the stack, so which condition will arise? We have already discussed in the previous lecture, the condition of overflow. So I hope you understood the concept of push operation, or you can also call it as insertion in stack. Now let's understand it with the help of algorithm. So now we will study the algorithm for insertion or push operation in stack. So we have an array here, which we represented with stack. We have the top pointer, which will be pointing to the last location in the given stack, the topmost element, and data is the value that we want to insert into the stack, right? So now let's understand the first step. First step is, first of all, we will name the algorithm as stack underscore push. Here we have three parameters. First is your stack. Then we have the top element. Then we have the top pointer, which is pointing to the topmost element in the stack. And we have the data that we have to insert, because in insertion, we should also have the data. Now in step one, the first condition is, like, we have to insert anything into the data structure. The first and foremost condition for every data structure will be, we have to check whether the data set is full or not. So if it is full, there is no point of adding anything into it. So we have to simply print an overflow message which states that the stack is full and we cannot further insert anything into it. So simply overflow message shows that the stack is full. So there is no space to insert data in the stack. This was about step one. What about step two? So if in this case, the stack is full, but in the second case, the stack is not full, right? So the stack, in that, the top can be pointing anywhere. It can be empty or it can be pointing to any other location. So in first case, it can happen that the stack will, the top will be pointing to -1. In that case, what will happen? It will be -1 + 1, top will be updated with 0 and stack 0. So at 0th location, we'll be inserting the data. Also, it can be a case that your stack, your top is pointing to, let's say, second location. So in that case, top will be 2 + 1, that is 3. So top will be updated with 3 value and stack third location. In stack third location, we are inserting the data, right? So this is the first condition in if, where we are checking if the top is pointing to size -1. In that case, your top pointer is pointing to the last location and there is no chance of inserting anything into it. So we will print an overflow message which states that there is no capacity in the stack. In step two, in else condition, we will update the value of the top pointer. So the top can be pointing to -1 or it can point at any other location in the stack. So first your top pointer will be incremented by 1, and then at the new location of the top, you will be inserting the data. So value is inserted in the stack at the top position. So this was all about the algorithm of push in stack, right? And then we'll finally exit. Now, what is the time complexity of push operation in stack? So we have to just insert the element at the given location, and to directly insert the element at the given location, that is the last location of the array, we are given the index and we have to simply assign the value at that location. So it will simply take constant time, and that constant time will be represented by O(1). So push operation in stack takes O(1) time, that is constant time. So this was all about the basic of the insertion, or you can say push operation in stack. In the next video, we will study about deletion or pop operation in stack. Till then, stay tuned to my channel and wait for my next video. Thank you.